Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome back to Don't a Fools. Today's mission at hand is Operation Rapid Strike. Now, I had the choice between Rapid Strike and Scorpion. Scorpion is basically assaulting an air base and destroying all air assets, which I assume comprises of helicopters and aeroplanes and whatnot. Probably just helicopters, considering the fact that this is a Delta Force game in the end, and we haven't seen any aeroplanes yet. But then again, we hadn't really used the laser designator until recently either, so who knows. But maybe there are some grounded things that we need to destroy at any rate. I have chosen Rapid Strike because this is a little bit more familiar, and yeah, we'll go from there. We'll go from Rapid Strike. This is an elimination mission, just like Scorpion, but this is a command center. Now that is another one of the reasons why I've chosen this mission, because while crippling their air prowess might serve for better air superiority, if you cripple the leadership, that pretty much affects a lot of the enemy branches at the same time. So yeah, so what we will do is proceed with Operation Rapid Strike. That seems like a very short map, but packed with enemies. At least from what I can see, they are engorged inside of a, well, not engorged, how do I put this, they're pretty much packed inside of a valley of sorts, and they should be ripe for the picking, is what I feel like. So yeah, let's see what this mission is about. Execution. Black Widow will insert you in the hills approximately 255 meters from objective Hydra. Proceed northeast through the hills, attacking the objective through the south central perimeter. Your ingress route is plotted to take you around known bunker complexes. I see there are bunkers there, of course there are. In order for this mission to be successful, you must eliminate all personnel. Expected enemy forces, electronic intelligence. I wonder what that is. Eland, indicates that there are extensive enemy patrols around the objective. A Russian military advisor notes that it is normal for command and control centers to be guarded with two squads of highly trained soldiers in addition to outside patrols. Now, I actually looked up the size of a US Army squad and it said 4 to 12 soldiers strong. Now, even though Birds of Prey was supposed to have only one squad, it had something to the effect of maybe 50-ish soldiers. So yeah, that statistic is wrong here. Whenever they say squad, they probably mean around 40 to 50 soldiers is what I have come to learn. Anyway, moving on. Where was I? Maybe I should use, yeah. In addition to outside patrols, these facilities usually have artillery support and light attack helicopters. Okay, we do have helicopters as well, and we do have artillery that they can use against us. Great. Alpha and Charlie teams have already entered the operational area and are in position to assist your attack. Alpha team is currently located approximately 110 meters east of the objective, and Charlie team is dug in approximately 95 meters northwest. You can tell that Charlie team is really dug in into this tiny little crevice, convenient crevice right here of the objective. Upon receiving confirmation from you, both teams will move in. So how do I confirm their ingress? Probably by activating checkpoint 2, I suppose. Situation. Enemy resistance has been stiff. Ow. Let me just retry that. Enemy resistance has been stiff. Coupled with the difficult terrain, our advantage has been slow. The Meteorological and Oceanographic Forecast Center has issued warnings that adverse weather conditions are due soon. Joint Operations Command has issued a commander's estimate of the situation, which states that if the current tempo of operations continues, it may be necessary to cease offensive operations. The cold gets us all in the end, doesn't it? I mean, the Russians used it to great success in the Second World War, and the Napoleonic Wars for that matter. I mean, they just kept retreating, and when the cold came, the enemies didn't have anything to eat, and yeah, they just literally froze their asses off, that's one of the reasons why the country is so difficult to invade wars. I mean, now we have got, machines that can fly through the air, and air-conditioned tanks. Anyway. Excuse me. Politically, this alternative is unacceptable. Of course it is. we want to finish the mission as soon as possible. We don't want to give the enemy time to regroup and come up with alternative strategies and your plans to work against us. We can't exactly wait for the ice to thaw before we launch our offensive. So, and since we can't mount an offensive in the snow, we'll need to pretty much do it before it settles in. The military intelligence detachment has identified several key enemy command and control facilities, the loss of which will severely disrupt enemy military operations. Joint Operations Command has decided to strike all of these facilities simultaneously in an effort to break the logjam. Special Forces Command has been tasked with the destruction of the most isolated of these facilities. So there apparently are other teams, not likely Delta teams, but like other Special Forces which are targeting other bases in the area as well. This base, this particular base, which is sort of, you know, holds up in a valley, has been given to us, Delta Force. Now, I have got laws here, which I don't understand why, probably because of the helicopters in this situation. Spec Ops 45 and M4 seems like the ideal weapon selection to me. Let's go ahead and start this mission off then.
Bravo team, move into the camp. Alpha and Charlie, secure the perimeter.
Alpha team, set.
Charlie is at the perimeter. King 6 to all elements, you are clear to move in on the objective.
What I dislike about this mission is
Charlie, one is down.
How it essentially forces a style of combat that this game is not optimized for.
Alpha 1
die,
is down.
Come on, what the fuck? So, yeah, I mean, this game is not meant to support the kind of combat that it essentially enforces on you.
Watch the target! Watch the target!
Watch the target? Really? Now, there are a few other soldiers over there that I need
to kill. Charlie is down! Charlie is down!
Roger. Now, I just need to take out these guys, and once I've done that, I'll go ahead and begin my incursion into the camp. The incursion itself is pretty methodical, except for a few areas. And the previous time around, I had almost got it until one of the people managed to kill me. Well, not the previous time around anymore, like the time before that, because the previous time around I died in this encounter, and that's pretty much what this encounter, this entire section is. Like, once you get, if you can manage to get rid of the initial patrol here, then there's nothing really to stop you. Nothing can stop you after that. It's just this initial patrol that serves to be the most difficult part of this mission. And, I mean, I probably haven't reached the part where they're supposed to be helicopter yet, but yeah. You can hear the helicopter, but the helicopter never arrives. So, it's essentially sort of like a... Yeah, there he is. It's essentially sort of like a scenario where you keep hearing the sound of the helicopter, but you don't ever get to see it. There should be somebody on this roof as well. I think that's him right there. Oh yeah, he's dead. And that's another person over there. Now the camouflage, at least the enemy camouflage, until right up until the point that they're dead, is also super effective in the sense that I don't know who's shooting at me, honestly. In the sense that the enemies are impossible to notice unless, you know, you know beforehand where they are. And I'm just gonna circle around to get these two people. Hopefully it'll all be worth it in the end. But at any rate, saving Bravo and Charlie is... Sorry, I'm Bravo. Alpha and Charlie is a moot point. You will not be able to save them. You just have to live with the deaths. Now, these guys, this time around, seem to be pretty far. Farther, much farther than where they're supposed to be. Like, right around here. And I don't know if they're going to stay that way or not. But I intend to make sure that they do, in fact, stay that way. I do not want them coming over and assaulting me. That is not them. That is them. One of them, at least. Okay. You guys are dead. And the people on the other side of the hill, they don't really do much. They just pretty much stand there doing nothing. And yeah, with that done, I'll just begin my incursion into the base. I've been retrying this mission for quite a few times now, and it's just difficult in general. Because they pretty much force the pace of the entire firefight on you. And this game isn't really optimized for the kind of firefights that this, that they force you into, because you're supposed to head down there and start shooting everybody, but it's not an action shooter. This game is not an action shooter by a long shot. So essentially what ends up happening is you have a game where you can't like do anything pretty much. You're stuck. You keep dying. So, yeah, I mean, it's sad, but it is what it is, I suppose. And there are lots of people still roaming around down there. I don't know how many people are up here. I do not think there are any people up there. I cannot see anybody. There he is. One of yous running on top of that hill over there. There's another one of yous. Two people near the bunker, one inside, one near it. I'll probably take you out when I get near that bunker myself. So, with that being said, let's take this a little cautiously. Let's go prone instead. That greatly reduces our profile and makes us difficult targets. We can't be hit that easily. There's another guy over here, and should be another guy over there. Yes, indeed there is. I can still not see anybody in the bunker. Yep, nobody dead in the bunker yet. I think that is another person. Yeah, we have already shot them. That person is also dead. Caution is the name of the game in this level. Now, there's somebody near this truck. I don't know who it is or where this person is, but there's somebody near this truck. I thought it would be somebody in front of the truck. Maybe it's the truck itself that is registered as an enemy. But yeah, you need to essentially destroy the truck. Otherwise, it won't count as an enemy kill. Where else? As we keep moving, we'll see newer enemies just pop up on the screen. I think there's another enemy right near that barrel over there. Sorry. Of course, I cannot tell for sure at this point, but I think there is at least one enemy over there. Now, as for this truck, I'll probably save it for later. Executing that truck, I mean. There is an enemy down there that I decided to take out with not so extreme prejudice. But with prejudice nonetheless. The reason I'm crawling is so that my profile remains low. And for some reason in this game, crawling makes you far more difficult to notice. And I'll just wait for the game to stop lagging before I take my shot. I think I can see the enemy there. I think that is the enemy. It just had to start lagging immediately, didn't it? And now this enemy is aware of me. Yep, there, that guy's finally dead. So just keep checking for enemies and keep proceeding. By the time that an enemy starts shooting at you, or you are actually in contact with an enemy, it might be too late. So yeah, remain a little proactive is essentially Not proactive, rather. Remain a little cautious in your approach, is what I would say. Now, yeah, there you are. I think I am becoming better at clearing out this area. There should be another enemy in front of that compound over there. I believe that is him. Yes, it is. Tight angle, but an angle nonetheless. And as for these enemies here, I'm just gonna go ahead and use the law. That only took out one of them? Oh no. I was hoping it would take out more. I actually hit the wrong truck. That is my bad. And I wasted the law in the process. Probably should have just used the grenade launcher from the beginning. Now, what I'll do next is I'll go up near that bunker or maybe up on that hill over there and attempt to start, you know, tagging the enemies from there. I can hear the helicopter and you can hear the helicopter from time to time, and I don't know whether it is sort of a warning to you that you're getting off track or something. But yeah, after a certain point of the game you can start hearing the helicopter a lot. So it's not something that you do. I haven't faced the helicopter yet because the game has either bugged out before that, or I have died before it. Before the fact, I mean. Before ever being able to face the helicopter. Is one of those people dead yet? No. Nobody is dead yet. I'll just stay here. I will not be entering the bunker yet. But I will try to get an angle on it from whence I can shoot the enemies. Now there, I am getting hit with some shots. Apparently one of them has broken through the bunker and is heading downhill, becoming the prime opportunity for a succulent target, becoming a very succulent target. Now yeah, all guys dead over there. Now what remains, I think, are two people inside of either inside that building or around it. I know for sure that at least one of them is inside that building. So I'll go on top of this mountain here and I'll try to see if I can angle the shot. There are some people behind that mountain, but they usually do not disturb you as far as I've seen. So I suppose it's perfectly fine if we just stay here. I cannot see the enemy this time around. There is an enemy somewhere over there. I know it for certain because I have seen it before, this enemy. Like, I've killed him before. And from a similar angle nonetheless, I think that is one of the enemies. Yep. One of them is dead, and the other one is probably inside this house as well. We just need to be cautious in our approach and not get too greedy. Yeah, let us descend from here. I do not think there are any more enemies on the map. At least as far as we are concerned, anyway. And there are some patrols out there. I don't know whether we have to deal with them or not. But one thing that I do not intend to do is spend too much time inside of this base. Because the longer you stick around these buildings, the more are the chances that it will glitch out. And that is something which you want to avoid at all costs. The game glitching out, I mean. Now, you'll be able to hear the helicopter very often. Let me just go ahead and pull out my grenade launcher. The sound keeps coming and going. I haven't really been able to make sense of it. This guy isn't dead yet. Not yet. Not yet. Come on. That probably didn't even scratch the surface. I just need to be cautious not to get shot by this guy, wherever he is. Yeah, that guy's dead now. Officially dead. Primary objective achieved.
Hold your positions. Black Widow is inbound.
Roger, King 6. I just hope that I do not actually have to...
This is Black Widow. ETA is 3 mics. Black Widow to Bravo. Prepare for pickup.
Roger, Black Widow. And I suppose that was the sound of our own helicopter over there. Or maybe it's the Gazelle that was supposed to come but does not come because of a bug. But at any rate, yeah, finally this mission is a success, and let me just read the briefing before the game bugs out again. Number of kills 29. I'm guessing either Alpha or Charlie team killed a few of the people there. Your timely capture of the enemy command and control center provided a much needed blow to enemy plans. Taking advantage of the confusion created, allied ground forces have begun to make significant advances against enemy forces. It appears that they will be forced to put forces back just as the weather front hits. I see. Prisoner interrogation has revealed the location of the enemy's main satellite and uplink complex. As soon as weather permits, Bravo team will be given the order to destroy the station. Additionally, Bravo team is to remain ready to react instantly upon receiving notification of downed pilots in the area of responsibility. Now, I usually like those downed pilots missions. They are pretty adventurous. Or they were at least in those biggest time gap. Let's see how they are in this gap, because I think they would be pretty torturous given how the campaigns in this missions in this campaign have been thus far. But we have officially completed Rapid Strike, which has unlocked another mission called Fallen Ancients, and I'm pretty sure it's a mission where we have to go rescue a crew or something. Yep, rescue a crew of downed friendly command helicopter. So the next time we come back, since this is a priority mission, we will go for Fallen Ancients, and then we will target Operation Scorpion, unless this mission unlocks another similar mission like this. So, as for today, thank you for tuning out into Watch Rabbit Strike. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.